come out with. That's why God doesn't want lazy people. Mm. Every man of God has a work to do before God calls him. Peter was a fisherman. Paul was a third minister. This man was doing something. Some people are working, they don't want to do anything. Ministry are not for lazy people. If you ever marry to a minister or stay with a minister, you realize that it is one of the hard-working jobs. It's not a lazy thing. So, that's why you have this 2x4 Shenkong pastors. They are there. So they are lazy people. Real ministry, you must be engaged in productive work, and then God will call you. If you are faithful in little things, God will give you great.
Amen.
Bishop, say, say.
Oh. Amen.
If you want to come to ministry, go and work. Yes. And if you are faithful in little things, God will call you into higher things. Amen. Some of us, you think the ministry is little. See, preaching is the least thing in ministry. Preaching, what I'm doing is the least. The major work is behind the closed doors. The prayer, the traveling, the kind of agony that we go through, the administration, and all things that we have to put in place to make sure that the system works. It is not something that you must learn it outside. You must manage your own house. That's why a pastor must manage your house well before you manage the church. You must manage a company, and the company should be not be insolvent, what you call it, fire. No, you must do it so that it will be productive. Then you can do it. If you are not very careful and you are doing fire company, and they call it to a meeting, the church is going to fire.
That's true.
Kofi Akwa! The man of God was doing his normal work. If God will call you, it doesn't matter the work you are doing. You can be a doctor like Dr. Nyabu, he will call you. You can be a politician like Pastor Kofi, he will call you.
Amen.
It doesn't matter. And the fact that you, any work that you are doing, God can call you.
Amen.
And you see, from Alpha to Zoology, you can find the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Is the architect, bread of life, is the lion of the tribe of Judah, is the rose of Sharon, is the I can call it the bread of life. In the Bekara is the bread of life. So every profession, you can find yourself in the ministry. So don't look down on you. Paul was highly educated. God picked him up. And because of his education, God used him better, greater than Peter.
Yes.
Although Peter walked with Jesus. So education is also necessary.
Yes.
Don't let anybody fool you. School and fan culture. No. That person is fooling you. Yes and yes. School is also good.
Yes.
Jehovah.
They'll tell you, school, it doesn't matter. I mean, Peter, when they saw that he worked with Jesus Christ, and they realized that they are on school. The word on school doesn't mean they don't go to school. It is the word they use in a grammar. They have never seen to have sat under the feet of a qualified rabbi. But later they realized that he was with Jesus.
Amen.
The rabbi of all rabbis.
Yes.
So schooling is part of the work.
Amen.
If you are schooling, continue.
Amen.
If the Lord will take you, take
it. Amen.
And call you, call you. The Bible says, study to show yourself
approved.
Every profession can be used in the ministry.
Amen. Yes.
I use my profession in the ministry. And that's helping.
That's right.
So every profession is needed in the ministry. Mm. Don't think God is looking for lazy people who don't know anything, they don't want to work, and say, God, use me. No. Even the 5 talents, the lazy person said, what you have, they will get it from you. I want to lay a spiritual emphasis before I leave this, so that those who God will use, you know that if you are even in your work, whatever you are doing, don't worry yourself. God will call you.
Yeah. Amen.
So the guy was doing his work. He was plowing. And then the man of God passed by. He didn't even know. And while the man of God was passing, He took his mantle. You see, calls out levels. It is not the first anointing or the hand they lay on you. Then see, some people, they come to church and they answer, and then tomorrow then they start ministry. And then they go and take Unusual's name, Reverend Dr. Bishop, so-so-so, Prophet. I always say that if you give yourself a title, which you are not entitled to have it, ecclesiastical title, you face demons of the same equivalent. You have to defend your title.
Yes.
You are not a bishop, and you are calling yourself bishop. Satan will come with bishop temptation. Vagabond anoint you.
Amen.
They don't know anything. They don't. The God has so called. The fact that they lay hands on you once. Then, oh, now I've arrived. I'm now the minister. They put the minister. So now you stop them. You are now higher than your district pastor. You are higher than your elders. You are higher than your district. Somebody say, I'm talking to you.
I'm talking to you.
Pastor Bona, they run from place to place like them. You say, I'm running to and through. Be careful of ecclesiastical title. It is a dangerous thing that if you are not very careful, Satan will drown you in it. And the Bible says, anoint Elisha in your place. So whilst he was passing, he took his mantle. He didn't pray for him. Listen to me. He placed his mantle upon Elisha. And Elisha was spiritual sensitive. Many people are spiritually dead. Insensitive about spiritual things. Whilst I'm preaching, some people are caught in the revelation they gave up. I didn't ask them, but they know spiritual things.
Yes.
There are a lot of people who are in the church, they are not spiritually sensitive. And when anointing is passing, they can't know. They are waiting till anointing will be living in the state and they come for consultation. But that woman with the issue of blood said, Jesus is passing this way. And it's not waiting for Jesus to save her. Say, I can run and tap into that way. May God have mercy. May God have mercy.
Amen.
He placed his mantle on him. Mantle are used to cover oneself, to give warmth. A mantle represents the presence of God upon the man of God as a covering. Many men of God are going out without a covering. But Elijah, when he placed the mantle on Elisha, Elisha realized that something has happened. He even in the Old Testament, did something which Peter in the New Testament could not do. He ran after him and said, Master, he said, yeah, let me go and kiss my mom and dad. He said, we'll go and come. And he went. And the Bible says, he cut his yoke of oxen. And then he made party. Even the instruments, he used it as an offering to cook. Many people have come into the ministry and they have not sold what they have or got rid of what they have. Peter, when God called him, Jesus called him, he came. But he left his boat in charge of someone in case the ministry didn't go to the boat.